Hello, we are discussing about GATE 1988 ECE paper, and this question is related to analog circuits. Look at the circuit diagram given. It is Darlington pair transistor. Each transistor in the Darlington pair has HFE of 100. The overall HFE of the composite transistor is neglect the leakage currents. By neglecting leakage currents, what is the overall HFE of the composite transistor? Generally, Darlington pair, even though it consisting of internally two transistors, it will be treated as a single transistor only. That's why it is called as composite transistor. So you can think it is, this is going to be a block. Okay. So it is treated as a single transistor, which will be having three terminals, base, collector and emitter, but internally has two transistors, Q1 and Q2. And this is nothing but IC1. Collector current of Q1, and it is IE1, which is same as IB2. Base current of Q2 transistor is same as emitter current of Q1 transistor, and the input current is nothing but IB1. Collector current of overall collector current is IC. Okay, this is what IC2, and this current is going to be treated as it is IE2. So overall HFE is nothing but simply overall HFE is, we are going to calculate overall HFE is equal to IC2 divided by IB1. That is collector current of second transistor divided by base current of first transistor. Collector by base current is nothing but overall, generally it is treated as HFE. HFE is nothing but current gain. Okay, current gain is output current by input current. So for a single transistor, collector current by base current. Since it is composite transistor, Q2 at the output side. So IC2 divided by IB1 will be treated as overall HFE. Okay, now we are going to write IC2. IC2 can be written as IC2 is equal to beta 2 or HFE2, since it is given in terms of HFE. IC2 is equal to HFE times of, because HFE2 you can write, but HFE of both the transistors are same. So I am writing it as HFE times of IB2. And HFE times of IB2, IB2 is nothing but same as IE1. So I can write it as IE1. And IE1 is nothing but HFE times, 1 plus HFE times of IE1 is equal to 1 plus HFE times of IB1, because IE1 is equal to IC1 plus IB1. IC1 is equal to HFE times of IB1. You can write IE1 as 1 plus HFE times of IB1. So this is what IC2. So overall HFE is equal to IC2 divided by IB1. So IC2 divided by IB1 is nothing but HFE times of 1 plus HFE. So this is going to be 100 into 101. 100 into 101 is equal to 10,100. So the right answer for this question is C. Otherwise, if it is, instead of asking overall HFE, it may be asked about the overall current gain. Overall current gain, if it is asked, what can be the right answer? Okay, this is Darlington pair is going to be consisting of two common collectors. Remember it. Darlington pair always consisting of common collector and common collector combination. So for common collector, emitter is going to be output current. So this will be treated as IE2 divided by IB1 is nothing but overall current gain. So in this case, okay, you can write it as IE2 divided by IB1. So this will be 101 times of, similarly it is, instead of IC2 you are writing it as 1 plus beta. So this will be 101 into 101 you will get. So this going to be 10,201, and it is approximately equal to 10,200. So the right answer is D, if it is asked about overall current gain of Darlington pair. But what was asked is nothing but overall HFE only. HFE is nothing but collector current by base current, that is output collector current by base current. HFE is current gain, that too in common emitter mode. HFE, E implies nothing but is, it is assuming that one, the transistor is biased in emit common emitter mode. So for common emitter, HFE is always defined as IC divided by IB only. For composite transistor, IC is collector current of second transistor, IB is base current of first transistor. So this will be IC2 divided by IB1. So the answer is 10,100. If it is asked as overall current gain, then it could be 10,200. So right option for the given question is C. Thank you.